NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 28 in our series, Build a RubyGem NerdDice. And we're going to move up in our backlog, adding a code coverage plugin. So I'm going to look at simplecov and coveralls, which is free for open source, and we're going to try this out. So do open source sign up, click on GitHub sign up, so it looks like by default it tries to get you to do the trial here. Do you want to grant that to stateless code? Still trying to see if I can add some repos here. So we definitely want stateless code NerdDice. Maybe it will just work and it was trying to upsell me. Well, yeah, that looks like what it was trying to do was upsell me. So we'll see if we can configure this. So they've got the lemurheavy version of Coveralls Ruby, and then Coveralls Reborn appears to be maintained better. We're going to try that. So we'll add that as a development dependency for our bundle. And we're also going to, in the process, knock out, you can see this dependabot alert for RE XML. So we'll do this and update our bundle as we're going here. So in our gemspec, we'll add a development dependency. Before we do that, we'll check out a new branch. So we'll try that. We will do a bundle update. rspec. Ooh, we've got some changes related to those are all just in our gemspec itself. Got some information about our RuboCop, how up to date it is, but that is something we can save for another video. We will continue on with trying to do some interaction here, so want to our spec helper. So the normal docs here say that I can do require, in this case, probably Coveralls Reborn, and then do coveralls.where. So we'll see how that works in our helper. I think it says to do this before you require your application code. Yes, before any of your application code is required. See what happens here. All right. Cannot load such a file. I might be able to just do, maybe it's still calling itself coveralls. That seems to have worked. Outside of the CI environment, not sending data. Let's make sure our coverage is there, but empty. Make sure we add that to our gitignore. Coverage is already there, so we're good. Let's see. want to add this now so that it works in our GitHub action. See what happens there. So I'll go to our main file here. So we're running our tests, and then see what happens. Check out our diff. Make sure it's only the changes that we intended. It appears to be. Let me just check gemfile.log to make sure that, yeah, it looks like so that's at 3.2.5. Patch version is 3.2.5, so that should solve that. Well, write our commit message. So we've got our message, sign the commit, and we'll try to push it. And we'll see if anything happens in our GitHub actions. Pause and let this complete. So our job failed here. RuboCop failed because I didn't add in the line after the magic comment. And then our test files failed because it's not using lcov.info, which is what it's configured as. So let's take a look at these. All right, we're back to normal on RuboCop. And now let's take a look at what gets updated here. So they all get updated, but we're not getting things written to that simplecov.lcov file. I think the simplest thing to do is to just see if this will work in our specific file. It doesn't look like it's configured. So it turns out I didn't have stateless code NerdDice turned on. So let's, and I fixed RuboCop, so let's recommit here. See if that solves anything. So go check the actions. And we still failed. We're still getting Lcov file not found. All right, so we're going to try a little bit of formatting here. Take a look at what where does here. So that in. See if this also require use that. Copy that whole block. Let's see. All right. See if that solves it. So we failed this time because of an inability to load simplecov-lcov. take a look at our not in our gem file. We'll explicitly add that as a development dependency. Right, it is. RuboCop's good. And see if we get a better error message. Sometimes that's the level of progress that you need, is just to progress from one error message to another. See if we got a new one. So that seems to have errored out. So it's that formatter. Issue that we because that's in a block. So seems to have worked. And we have failed again. Let's take a look at what happened. we're back to Lcov file not found. Pause and take a look at the docs. All right, so maybe what I need to do is just get coveralls out of here. Well, temporarily comment them out if RuboCop won't get angry. They do not. So we're green now. That doesn't mean that we actually got anything back. Let me make sure there's nothing confidential here. This just gives us badging info, which we will do. So it looks like I might have forgotten this finish part needs to run after all other steps are completed. So let's try adding that. Breaks there. And we'll see if that solves our... Nope, that definitely didn't solve anything. Workflow is not valid. Depends on unja. Need to name the job properly. Depends on test rspec. Again. All right, so we're not automatically red. We'll let it run. So our job finished green. The finished job finished. if we go to Coveralls and refresh, hey, we've got coverage and information about our build and our branch. Let's go back and clean up. So get rid of the commented code. Run RuboCop. The question is whether now I even interactively rebase against master. I'll reword that potentially. Probably don't need to. Yeah, that's all still more or less accurate. Successfully rebased. Just got the one commit ahead of master now. And so we will modify and sign our commit. We will do a force push. And then, assuming this passes the build, we will open a pull request to master. I mean, we're going to do that anyway, so we'll I think this is referenced in the pull request. Those are both running in parallel. We'll let those complete. They both completed successfully. Branch, push our branch, and our pull request is merged. Close that with a comment, go back to our master branch are dependabot warnings are gone. Our coverage is currently showing as unknown, but that action is still running. And we've got to give it a couple moments after the build finishes, but now you can see we've got our nice little coverage badge. It's at 100%, and it will take us to the Coveralls section there. So we have successfully added our code coverage. It's at 100%, which it was good. We didn't have to fix that. And now we'll have that available every time we have a push or pull request on our repo. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.